Hey there. What can I do for you? All I know is I'd like to speak to Griff myself. If we have time, I'd like to go talk to the Zerker Corp rep on Tatooine and see what he has to say about where my brother is now.
I feel I must apologize for the way I acted towards you before, in the Grove. It was wrong of me. I am sorry for attacking you. I am sorry for thinking you would only try to kill me. I hope that by helping you in your task, I may redeem myself in your eyes, and in my own. Thank you. It is most reassuring to know that you can forgive me, even though I tried to take your life. I can only hope that, in our time journeying together, I will succeed.
Yes, what's on your mind?
You got it.
How can I help? Yes, I suppose I can understand your curiosity given the bond that connects us. Very well. I'll tell you a bit about myself. I was found to be strong with the Force at a young age, as most Padawans are. As a girl, I was given to the Order to be trained. When I joined the Order, I left my family on Tal'Ravan, as all Padawans do. My family is still there, the last that I heard. I've had little contact with them, as it is discouraged. Relationships with family members are fraught with powerful emotions. Such extremes are to be avoided. Anger and hate are the worst, but even love can lead to folly. Like all who join the Order, I have learned to embrace the life I've chosen. I had to let go of my attachments to my family. It can be a hard lesson to learn. I was not on good terms with all of my family, but I do remember missing my father terribly for a long time. Very close. I was only a little girl when I left my family, but I still remember him fondly. He was kind and gentle and doted on me. My mother, however, was different. I was not on good terms with my mother. I was only a little girl when I left, but I was old enough to resent her and the way she treated my father. She pushed my father into treasure hunting. I spent all my young life on ships, traveling from one false lead to the next. She whittled away my father's entire fortune, and I hated her for it. I think she was relieved to give me to the Jedi, but my father was heartbroken. A child is too young to understand the sacrifices that must be made. It's better if they have no contact with their family once they're removed. Once I was older, I realized the wisdom of this policy. A Jedi must do what is needed, personal desires notwithstanding. Love can only obscure and confuse the matter. Even a Jedi cannot always control the feelings of the heart. We must do our best to guard against it, no matter what the cost. But some sacrifices are harder than others. I do not wish to discuss this anymore. I would rather return to our mission.
Lord Malak, the Star Forge is operating at 200% capacity, far beyond our expectations.
I am more interested in the young Jedi Bastila and her battle meditation. Have you learned how she escaped the destruction of Taris?
She was aided by Karath, a decorated war hero of the Republic and a legendary soldier. During the Mandalore Wars, he was honored many times for his bravery.
You know this man?
Yes, Lord Malak. He served under me when I still followed the Republic. You could say I was his mentor.
Interesting. How did you acquire this information, Admiral?
An eyewitness, Lord Malak. Calo Nord, a bounty hunter, was there when Bastila and Karath escaped the planet. Apparently, they left him for dead.
A Jedi and a war hero. It's a wonder you survived the encounter.
I am hard to kill, Lord Malak.
Calo has agreed to help us capture the young Bastila for a very hefty fee, of course. But I assure you, he is well worth the price. His reputation as a bounty hunter is well earned.
Her companions are nothing to me, Calo. But I desire the young Jedi taken alive, if at all possible.
Lord Malak, forgive me. There is something else. May we have a private audience away from the ears of the common soldiers?
I trust you are not wasting my time, Admiral Karath.
I promise you will be very interested in what Calo has to tell you about Bastila's other companions, Lord Malak.